of the Southern Wild, Dan Janvey, Josh Penn, and Michael Gottwald, producers.
Silver Linings Playbook, Donna Gelati, Bruce Cohen, and Jonathan Gordon, producers.
Zero Dark 30, Mark Bull, Catherine Bigelow, and Megan Ellison, producers.
Lincoln, Steven Spielberg, and Kathleen Kennedy, producers.
Les Miserables, Tim Bevan, Eric Fellner, Deborah Hayward, and Cameron McIntosh, producers.
Life of Pi, Gil Netter, Ang Lee, and David Womack, producers.
Amour, nominees to be determined.
Django Unchained, Stacey Scher, Reginald Hudlin, and Pilar Savone, producers.
And Argo, Grant Heslov, Ben Affleck, and George Clooney, producers.
Argo has been nominated. Somebody tell Cranston he can unclench his teeth now.
Morning, welcome back, everybody. I'm Soledad O'Brien, and joined this morning by HLN Showbiz Tonight anchor AJ Hammer. Welcome back. You're watching our special Oscars edition of Starting Point. We're going to join CNN Newsroom in just a couple of minutes.
But first, now that we know what is nominated for this year's Academy Awards, with the announcement coming just a few minutes ago, we want to go right out to Nichelle Turner. She's live at the Samuel Golden Theater in Beverly Hills. So, Nichelle, run through all the big awards for us.
Okay, we will do that, definitely. You know, the Academy has kind of the leeway to nominate anything from 5 to 10 movies for Best Picture. This year, they nominated 9 movies, and we saw those. First of all, Amour, Argo, Beasts of the Southern Wild, Django Unchained, Les Miserables, Life of Pi, Lincoln, Silver Linings Playbook, and Zero Dark Thirty. It was a really good year for movies, and the Academy gave a nod to a lot of great films. Also, the Best Actor category, a strong category, but a big snub, it seems, in this category. The nominees are Bradley Cooper for Silver Linings Playbook, Daniel Day-Lewis for Lincoln, Hugh Jackman for Les Miserables, Joaquin Phoenix for The Master, and Denzel Washington for Flight. No John Hawks for The Sessions, that a lot of people thought he would get a nomination. In the actors category, this seems to be shaping up maybe a two-woman race. Jessica Chastain for Zero Dark Thirty, Jennifer Lawrence for Silver Linings Playbook, Emmanuelle Riva for Amour was nominated this morning, Quvenzhané Wallis, who everyone's getting a big smile when they say her name for Beasts of the Southern Wild. 9 years old she is. And Naomi Watts for The Impossible. And if you saw that movie, such a great performance by Naomi Watts. We also have the supporting categories. And this, again, for the men, a very strong category. This year, the nominees for Best Supporting Actor are Alan Arkin for Argo, Robert De Niro for Silver Linings Playbook. We've also got Philip Seymour Hoffman for The Master, Tommy Lee Jones for Lincoln, and Christoph Waltz in Django Unchained. Some people thought maybe Leonardo DiCaprio would get a nomination in this category, or maybe Samuel L. Jackson would get a nomination in this category, but neither of those men did. For Best Supporting Actress, we've got Amy Adams for The Master, Sally Field for Lincoln, who was just masterful in that movie, Anne Hathaway for Les Miserables, Helen Hunt for The Sessions, and Jackie Weaver for Silver Linings Playbook. And we just heard Scott Feinberg say that it's been 31 years since a movie has been nominated in every major category, and that happened this year for Silver Linings Playbook. Guys, this could be the year of this small movie that, I have to say, was one of my favorites.
And yours and many others as well. All right, Nichelle, thanks so much. I want to get right to Jackie Weaver from Silver Linings Playbook. She's on the phone. She was just nominated as Best Supporting Actress for Silver Linings Playbook. And she plays Dolores Solitano, Bradley Cooper's mom, Robert De Niro's wife, and she's with us. So congratulations. Wake up. How'd you find out?
I was watching the television. I couldn't sleep. I was so excited. I'm here in L.A. I only got here from Australia yesterday. Because I'm going to make a movie in Texas, but I did not believe this was going to happen. I didn't think I had a chance. I'm so thrilled because it's such a beautiful film, and David O. Russell's wonderful, and of course we all were such a great team. I love Bradley and Jen and Bob. They're all fab. We had a great time.
Congratulations to you.
I think it is amazing.
And your body clock has to be all messed up right around now. Jackie, so you've seen the same material that we've been seeing in the run-up and during award shows, all of the critics and everybody, all the experts chiming in who they think will be nominated. Shamefully, your name has appeared on very few lists, which has to make this all the more rewarding for you. It's such a terrific way to get a nomination.
That's right. I honestly thought I didn't have a chance. But I consoled myself with the fact that the New York Times said I was sensational, and I thought I can live with that. That's enough. But to get this is so amazing, and of course it's my second one in 3 years, and I'm not a young woman, so I can't believe my luck.
It's wonderful. We're really excited for you. So who was the first person? You hear your name on the TV. You're now a nominee. Who's the first person you called?
I just got fired, actually.
I called my husband in Sydney, Australia, but I called him 3 times and I couldn't wake him up.
Maybe he'll get to see it on TV, too.
But then I got a call from my ex-husband, so I don't know what that means.
That's really exciting, as Nichelle was just mentioning, right? Nominated in every major category, which is such a big victory already, even before the actual award ceremony, for a small movie, you know, in some ways.
Yes, yes, I'm so happy for David O. Russell. I think he is, I know genius is an overused word, but I think David O. Russell is one of those. He's an amazing director. And, of course, for me to work with that icon, Mr. De Niro, was, like, amazing.
So how's it now? Do you work on your speech? Like, are you already just drafting it out, the big major outline? I mean, come on, like, honestly.
The pressure's on.
Yeah, how does that work?
Well, I do know Tom Hanks advises that you don't get out a piece of paper, because they know for a fact that millions of people turn the TV onto another channel as soon as you get out a piece of paper. So you've got to try and be as spontaneous as possible without reading it out, and just trust yourself not to forget people. But it's kind of high pressure giving an acceptance speech, and sometimes they can be really dull. I think it's important to make them interesting and lively.
Jackie, you should thank your ex-husband.
Well, Jackie, congratulations.
Yeah,
how terrific
news.
For
great
you.
News.
I know it's just good to be nominated, but we'll be pulling for you come Oscar night next month. Thanks for joining
us
this morning.
We have Naomi Watts on the phone as well. She's joining us by phone. Congratulations to you as well. Okay, we have her?
Do we have Naomi?
I'm not sure we have a connection with Naomi Watts.
She's not made, and she'll
we
be back
are having up some
Dan?
Technical difficulties.
Naomi?
Yeah. Naomi, are you here?
I'm here.
No,
she's
it looks like
here.
We're having some problems. We'll take a short break. When we come back, we will fix
Hello?
Our audiological.
There she is.
Hey,
you know,
Naomi.
Your phone gets all jammed up with everybody trying to call you when they hear the big
people
news.
People breaking in. Yeah. Nice to have you with us.
Hi.
Congratulations. Where are you right now, and how did you find out that you have an Oscar nomination?
I'm in my bed still. I'm in Los Angeles, and I watched on the television. I thought I wouldn't watch because I thought it would be too torturous if I didn't get nominated, but I couldn't sleep, and so I thought, I'm not going to lie here.
You sound very calm. You don't sound like you're freaking out. Are you freaking out on the inside? I mean, how do you
feel? I am. I've already had my little, you know, personal freak out in private.
This movie...
it's very exciting. I'm totally thrilled. I didn't sleep much at all last night, not just because of my tension and nerves, but also because my children, there were 3 different wake-ups in the night. So it didn't help. So, yeah, then I ended up just saying, oh, I'm going to turn on the TV. I texted my publicist and said, can you tell me which channel? And tuned in. And it was really, really great because normally with the W, you're always going to be the last on the list, but they mixed it up this year.
We're watching pictures from the film, and I covered this story, of course, the 2004 tsunami, and just to watch it, the reenactment of it, it makes my heart stop, honestly, because I saw the devastation in Thailand specifically as well. You have, I read, a tremendous fear of the water from childhood, is that right?
Yeah, that's correct. So my family immigrated from England to Australia when I was about 14, and we stopped in Bali in Indonesia on the way. And we were not great swimmers, and we didn't understand riptides and things like that. And we got caught in the riptide and just did the exact wrong thing and swam against it and got to the point of exhaustion. And kind of got to the point of giving up. And suddenly there was sand beneath my mother's feet, and she was able to pull me in. But it was very scary, and it left me with a sizable fear of the water, particularly when there's waves and strong currents.
Well, I think it's terrific that obviously this nomination and the other attention that the film is now getting in the awards season is going to bring a lot of eyeballs to a film, The Impossible, that a lot of people have yet to really know a whole lot about.
Oh, yeah, so that's wonderful. Congratulations to you. You may now go back to sleep, although I guess your phone will be ringing off the hook.
Yeah, it's literally buzzing in my hand.
Go answer all your well wishers. Thanks for talking with us and congratulations.
Congratulations. Well, shall we go to the man of the hour?
We shall. We should indeed. Seth MacFarlane, of course, he was really, really great as they were doing what sometimes is very stiff, the naming of the nominations. It was funny. It was wonderful with Emma Stone. Congratulations as well.
We need to say thank you, Seth.
Yes, exactly.
Thank you.
Thank
it
you
was
so much.
Such a cheerful way to start the day and a little different from, completely different from how we've seen it in the
past. I'm just a working American punching in, punching out.
So we need to know, though, how much prep went into that for you this morning? Because as much as I'd like to believe you got up there and winged it, which you certainly could, you did take a little time in advance, didn't you, to sort of get an idea of what was going to happen?
Yeah, no, I mean, not a whole lot. We don't really get the nominees until a few hours before. So it's you know, there's not a whole lot of time. So it's kind of slapped together. But we have a great team, and we were able to pull together something fun.
You're also nominated. That's exciting. I mean, is it?
Yes, I know. It's insane. I don't know how that happened. A horrible mistake has been made.
Seth, it's Jay Thomas. Good morning and congratulations, Seth.
Hey, thanks.
Have you already written the episode of Family Guy watching you on the Oscars?
You don't think that would be a little self-aggrandizing?
Well, I do. And I think you are self-aggrandizing deep down.
Okay, you win. You
all
win.
Right, yes, and will you have a 30-piece orchestra behind you at the Oscars?
I have a 30-piece orchestra behind me right now.
I know you do. I know.
I have one question.
They're just off camera.
Okay, good.
Hey, Seth. It's Bradley from Us Weekly. We wanted to know if you had run that joke by Harvey Weinstein before you dissed him in front of the
Us
entire
Weekly.
Globe.
God. I always get you guys mixed up with the New York Times, but you're two different publications, right? Us Weekly and New York Times, you're two different. No, you know, we didn't run it by Harvey Weinstein. We just figured let's just throw everything at the wall and see who gets mad.
Seth MacFarlane, wait, are there any no's that they've given you? Is there like a don't do this, don't do that? I mean, how are you prepping for it right now?
I mean, there have not been too many outright no's. We're all on the same page as far as what kind of line we want to walk. So it's a common sense thing. So it's not like we're going in there and, you know, pitching really, really hardcore Fox type jokes for the Oscars. We're trying to walk a line.
All right. Well, congratulations to you. We're looking forward. You've made that was so much more interesting than any announcement before. I cannot wait to watch the Oscars.
If the show itself doesn't work out, Seth, would you at least come back and host the nominations procedure every year for us?
Sure, sure. You know what? Yeah, I'll do that. In fact, I'll do that and that alone.
Great seeing you, Seth, and congratulations on your nomination. We'll see you next month at the Oscars.
We've got Roman Coppola.
Thanks, you guys.
You bet, you bet. Roman Coppola is joining us by phone. He wrote the screenplay for Moonrise Kingdom, along with Wes Anderson, right?
Yes.
So he's joining us by phone. Hey, congratulations to you.
Thank you so much. It's thrilling to hear this news today.
Yeah, tell me how you got the news.
You know, I was driving in the car with my family, and I was kept turning the radio up, and they kept going to other news breaks and stuff, and then my close friend texted me, and my mom started whooping and cheering in the car and kind of barking in her silly way, and my dad was very happy, and it was a nice celebration.
Well, for me, my favorite, shall we say, quirky movie of the past year, I am happy, as we always are for films that don't get a lot of attention, to know now that Moonrise Kingdom will get its due. I think it's terrific, Roman, that this film is finally going to hopefully get some traction and who knows, possibly walk away with some gold come next month.
That's wonderful. Well, I hope, this encourages more people to check it out, and we're very proud of it, of course.
Congratulations. It's wonderful news. We want to also thank our panel as well for being with us this morning, as we heard some shockers, I think, in terms of the snubs. Catherine Bigelow, quite a big snub by there, I think, when you consider all the time that was spent talking about the fact that she would be on the Best Director list.
You think she wants to waterboard the committee?
Perhaps.
Yes.
The Ben Affleck snub, though, I think
Ben Affleck.
This is something that literally since the movie was about to be released, everybody was talking about Ben not only as an actor and a possible Best Actor nominee, but also as the Best Director. To see it not get either of those is really surprising, but in the Best Picture category, we'll have to see what happens.